The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very humble. And he always used to, he was constant in his turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was constant in his turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the things the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for most constantly was for good character. One of the things the Prophet ﷺ used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the most was good character. For example, that he would say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Oh Allah, embellish my external and internal state. Make beautiful how I am outwardly and how I am inwardly." And the Prophet ﷺ also said, "Allahumma jannibna masawi al-akhlaq." And there's many, many du'as in which the Prophet ﷺ said, "Oh Allah, keep us away from bad character, from ugly character and conduct." Similarly, the Prophet ﷺ, when he used to look at the mirror, what did he used to say? That, "Oh Allah, just as you have made my form beautiful, make my character beautiful." Just as you have made my form beautiful, make my character beautiful. And Allah answered his call. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, "Ud'uni astajib lakum," call upon me, I will answer you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered this call of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did he answer the call? Imam Ghazali tells us, by the Quran itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disciplined the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the Quran. Someone came to Sayyidina Aisha. Right? His name was Sa'd ibn Hisham. And he asked her, radiallahu ta'ala anha, that how was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How was his character? Now Sayyidina Aisha was a no-nonsense kind of lady. She asked him, "Do you not read the Qur'an?" He said, "Yes, I do." So she said, radiallahu ta'ala anha, "Kana khuluquhu al-Qur'an." His character was the Qur'an. Now Sayyidina Aisha is brilliant. The Hanafi ulama, why do we consider her to be the best woman ever? It's a very controversial opinion. The ulama like arguing, right? The ulama like arguing. But that's like in any field. If you go to particle physicists, they'll be arguing. That's what people of knowledge do, right? Because they think a lot, and if you think a lot, you're going to disagree with others who think a lot. So they held that she was the best of human beings. Why? She was the best of women because she was the most knowledgeable woman in history. And the virtue of knowledge is greater than the virtue of lineage or the virtue of anything else. This of course got people very upset. Because what about Sayyidina Fatima? What about Sayyidina Khadija? What about Sayyidina Maryam? What about Sayyidina Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun, who's also mentioned in the Qur'an? So the strongest opinion about that issue is that each of these has a virtue that is unique to her. In terms of lineage, no one compares to whom? To Sayyidina Fatima, right? In terms of lineage, no one compares to Sayyidina Fatima. The Prophet ﷺ said, Fatima, bud'atun minni. Fatima is a piece of me. And she most closely resembled the Prophet in character and disposition. Sayyidina Khadija, she was the very first person to believe in the Prophet. And she was his first and most consistent supporter. So who can compare to that in that way? Sayyidina Maryam was unique in so many ways. And if you don't know what they were, read Surah Maryam. And similarly, Sayyidina Aisha, she was brilliant. She was one of the greatest legal thinkers. She was one of the greatest legal minds in humanity. Right? So she was asked to describe how was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Most people, if I ask you, describe his brother. Random brother one, stand up. Right? Now, if most of us had to describe random brother A, we would say, well, he's this tall, he's this thin, he's this that, he's sitting. Right? And we give a description. But Sayyidina Aisha, she didn't describe him. She distilled what she understood the prophetic character to be that his character was the Quran. Why? Because the Quran disciplined the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right? Every address in the Quran is first to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to whom it was revealed, and then to the rest of humanity. Right? This is why so much of the Quran says, "Say, right? Qul." Who is that to first and foremost? To the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right? And then from him to the rest of humanity. Right? From him, that message, because his duty was to convey that message to the rest of humanity. But he was the first person, he was the first person addressed by the Quran. And did he answer that divine address? Of course he did. Everything that Allah had called humanity to in the Quran, the Prophet ﷺ responded to it. And he embodied it most perfectly. So every virtue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises or calls us to, where can you find its most perfect, most excellent expression? In the person of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that he loves the people of tawakkul, the people of reliance upon him, that he is with the patient, that he is with the people of taqwa, of piety. Where can you find the most perfect example of trust in Allah, of patience, of piety, of love, of anything? In the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was addressed by these encompassing counsels in the Quran, right? In which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls him to the widest expressions of virtue. We'll take three examples, or perhaps four, I'm bad with numbers, okay, of these divine calls to the Prophet ﷺ on how he's supposed to be. The first of these, and this is one of the most amazing counsels, one of the most amazing advices in the Quran, it summarizes the way of good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. It's about seven words, and it summarizes the way of guidance. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, be easygoing. Be easygoing. Don't be excessively demanding on people. Don't give people a hard time. Don't, if they fall short, don't say, how come this and how come that? No, be easygoing. Be willing to overlook their faults, their mistakes, their shortcomings, their errors. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ, and command the good, call to the good, uphold what is good, what is praiseworthy, what is dignifying. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, and turn away from the ignorant. If someone's doing something foolish, someone's doing something wrong, the sunnah is to turn away from it. Right? So this is the first of these encompassing counsels. And the Prophet ﷺ embodied this most perfectly. Another counsel, and we hear this often at Jummah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى. Right? Verily Allah commands justice and excellence and giving to kindred, to one's family members. And he forbade wickedness, wrongdoing, and oppression. Right? This is a general